Welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here today. Today, I want to show you how you can remove all the hyperlinks in a Microsoft Word document in a single click so that you don't have to go through each one and start editing the hyperlinks through here, because that can take a long time if you have a long document with a lot of links. Let me show you how to do this today on Teachers Tech. So we are going to be using VBA today to create a macro that will be able to run to automatically get rid of all those links inside your Word document. But don't be scared off by this, because the coding that we're going to do is super easy. It's going to be two short lines, and once you create it, it'll be good for as long as you need it. And you can add some shortcuts to use it. I'm going to show you how to do that too. Okay, so first step is actually to turn on our developer tab. If you look across my tabs, I've turned it off. I had it on before, but it's not on by default, so I need to turn this on. Now, you can access this in a couple of different ways. The way I do it, I just right-click up here in the menu bar, and then you can see that we can go to Customize Ribbon, and then I can go to Customize Ribbon here and go down. And you'll see, so we're under the main tabs here, there's developer right here. So I'm just going to click on this and hit OK. And now if I look at my tabs, I have developer right there. You can access this through your options when you go back to home and under options as well. But I just tend to use that shortcut the way I showed you. Okay, so what's the next step now? We need to start our macro. So we're going to go over to our developer tab right here, and you're going to see that we have macros. And so I want you to go ahead and click this. And first of all, we need to give our macro a name. So what I'm going to call this is remove links, but we can't have any spaces in it. I'm just going to call it just like this. So when I go ahead, I get a name there, I can go ahead and hit create. And then it's going to open up VBA, so Microsoft Visual Basic for Applications. But don't be scared of this again. We're not going to add too much to this. We're just going to add a couple lines of code. And I'm going to paste mine in right here where the cursor is. I'm just going to go Control V. I already had it selected. I'm just going to hit Enter once here so you can see it. So this is what you need to type in. And I'm actually going to put it down below in the description so you can just copy and paste it into this as well. But it's Selection.WholesStory. So when this runs, it selects the whole story in here. It will select all my text. And then it will do this. So the selection fields, it will unlink any links in it. So that's all we need to do. We can actually just close out of this. So let's go ahead, and I'm just going to go up top, and I'm going to go to close out. You can see the shortcuts there. Just hit close. Okay, so we've created this macro. We can get to it in a couple different ways. If I go under view here, you can actually find it. If we go drop down under macros, we could go view macros, and I can run it by just clicking run. So click run. And it's done. It looks like it's all selected. But what I want to show you is that now if I go to any of these links, they're not links anymore. So I'm just going to go undo here one more time. And so just to show you before that these were all links, if I just click on them here, any of them, we can go ahead and see that there's links there. So I'll do this one more time. We just go up to our macros, view macros, run. And just click off it, and you can see all the links through this are gone now. I'm going to show you in a moment too how you can quickly get rid of all this underlining and colors without having to go to each one in a moment too. But what I want to show you now is actually how to add a shortcut. So we can have our macros run it this way, but you can actually create a shortcut out of your macros too. So to do this, I'm going to go back to my customize the ribbon. I'm just right clicking up here in the ribbon, and I'm going to open this up. We can create a shortcut for this macro. So if we go to customize here, and then you can see if I scroll all the way down here, there's macros. So I have this remove links. This is the macro that we created here. I can go ahead and create a shortcut for this. And so what I can do, now I'd recommend using your Alt, Control, and Shift keys all at the same time and then adding another letter so that you don't get mixed up with any of the default word shortcuts. So I'm just gonna go hold down Alt, Control, and Shift, and I'm gonna add an R in there. So I can see that we have my new shortcut key here, and I'm just gonna hit Assign and close like this, and I hit okay. So now if I was going to go and use my Alt, Control, Shift, and R, you can see it's running the macro at the same time. So you can create these shortcuts for this by doing what I just showed you here. Okay, so now the problem is we took away all our all the different links, but now the formatting, you can actually just use replace and go through the whole document and replace this using, so what I'm gonna do is go up back to my home here. So I'm gonna go all the way over here to just select replace. And when this opens up, what I wanna do is actually go to more, because we're gonna actually search for the it being underlined, and we're gonna change it to not being underlined and change the color back to normal. So what is it we want to find? So I'm gonna select it up here, and then I'm gonna go down to format, and I'm gonna choose font. So what is it I'm looking for? So I'm gonna find things that are underlined here and just hit okay. Now, what do I want to have happen? Well, I want the things that it finds underlined here are gonna be, I'm gonna just go back to my font again with replace with, and we'll say replace with none. Make sure that we have no underline, and we'll make it just automatic like this so that it's gonna replace with the automatic color and hit okay. So let's try it just once, hit replace. Replace, and we'll get replace all. So I'm going to hit okay. I'm going to close out of this now, and you can see all of those are gone. So it's a quick way to change your formatting using the replace by just looking at the font if you did have all those underlined. So I hope you like this tutorial today on how to remove hyperlinks with a single click automatically using VBA and creating those macros. Let me know what else you're looking to learn with Microsoft Office or Excel or other tech. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.